Precision Miniatures Sunset Coach Division makes and sells models of professional cars, ambulances, hearses, even funereal flower cars. And though these have been uniformly well received by the hobby because of their quality and authenticity, feature hounds like myself have always wanted Precision to go just a little further and give us engine detail and full-on access to the interior. I am Joe Kelly Jr. This is Playing with Cars. In response to some of our pleading, Precision has just released a brand new image, a 1959 Cadillac Series 75 Fleetwood Imperial Sedan Limousine. How'd they do? Come on, I'll show you. '59, fins and flash were in, and the name Cadillac really meant something. Driving one showed the world that you'd arrived. Being driven around in one meant that you'd been there for some time. Now, once the domain of the custom coach builders, limousines, and town cars built on Cadillac chassis were always desirable. But when Cadillac bought the Fleetwood Body Company in the late 1920s and put them to work as the in-house carriage makers for their Fleetwood series of limousines, there was a marriage of Cadillac technology and Fleetwood luxury. In 1959, 690 of these giant cars were built on a wheelbase that ran close to 150 inches. Overall length ran to over 20 feet. Add on the Caddy's already larger-than-life fins and otherworldly amounts of chrome, and you had a truly dramatic automobile. Now, Precision Miniatures is hoping that a few heads will turn to their model in 1/18 scale. The usual Precision Miniatures quality is here, but this is a full-access image with lots to show and a whole lot to tell about. At a little under 14 inches, you're going to need a bit of space to fit this one in. It's a giant model. Long, low, beautifully proportioned with a tall, formal roof and all the swoop and sweep that the real car had. The first thing that hit me about this model was the build quality. Not only is it beautifully painted in chrome, this model, the very model that has been to virtually every trade show and industry event for the past year or so, has survived countless door openings and closings, innumerable peaks beneath the hood, and more than a few slams of its trunk lid. But it's still tight and straight and it polished up to a near-perfect shine and luster. Also available in silver or white and rolling on neat, sweet white walls, the model's got four opening doors, an opening hood and trunk, and steerable, posable wheels. The casting is outrageously well done. Not only are the shut lines uniform and close, the added-on chrome pieces, and there are a ton of them, are set into the big metal body to precision-grade tolerances. The cowl vent, the grille, and the rear panel have been relief painted. That really makes the details pop. And the fitment of the match-painted plastic roof, the lensing, and the glazing all around is perfect. Check out these wheel covers. You had a choice of fabrics in the top-shelf Fleetwood, and while not as exotic or as varied as some offered by the custom houses, the Bedford wool surfaces were available in fawn or gray, and were even available for the driver. The option for Jeeves was a black leather bench, and that's what this model sports, done in a nice black plastic casting in front of a deeply detailed dash and gauges. Between chrome door sills and above a gray flocked floor, PM's laid the detail in big time. The textured top of the dash has vent holes punched into it and an automatic headlight dimmer, the Autronic Eye, on top, and that's been detailed right to its lens. The headliner's been flocked too, and if you follow it back over the clear divider, you'll land squarely in the lap of luxury and a lot of nice detail and features. Castings have been blasted with a textured paint, and they look and feel like sturdy cloth. Footrests are secured above the carpet, and if you hook a finger in here, you can pull down and set up the jump seats. There's a dome light above and a vanity setup for both rear seat passengers, not to mention a few nicely done buttons and handles placed in here. This was high luxury in 1959, and PM's brought it out very, very well. One of the new features, of course, is this opening trunk, and PM's laid on the carpet and some beautiful under-lid detailing. The spare is bolted down and capped with a trim plate, and the area is most remarkable for its utter lack of remarkability. It just looks clean and correct all the way around. Caddy's 390 V8 was adequate to pull the big car around, if a little slower than it did in other Caddies, with a respectable 325 horsepower and a huge 430 pound-feet of torque at only 3,400 RPM. With a great deal of cast, flexible wiring and plumbing attached, the Caddy blue block and all of the ancillary bits look great, if occasionally a little plasticky, with every single assembly and accessory getting a good deal of detailing and hand-picked paint. These guys have really stepped up to the plate here. It's completely wired and piped. There are spark plug leads and flexible cooling hoses, a cabled-in battery, and added radiator for either the AC or the hydromatic trans. It doesn't have the underhood flash of some models, but the true-to-life colors, textures, and the overall thoroughness of the detailing makes this effort from Precision Miniatures very worthwhile. Now, I may be wrong about this, but I believe that what we're looking at here is the largest single plastic casting currently in use under a model car. I'm only half kidding. True to form, the assembly of these relatively few pieces is clean and precise. There isn't a trick suspension or a set of brake lines, but the model's belly is still a clean, well-rounded rep of the Big Caddy's basement. Now, that's what these models have always brought to this hobby. Clean assembly, great paint and chrome, and a level of value that we can all appreciate. And what's great about this particular model is that Precision Miniatures has bumped up their game and given us full-on interior detailing, a fully loaded trunk, and a complete set of engine details. And they haven't compromised their quality, not one bit. I recommend this model very highly, whether you're a collector of professional cars or a fan of old Cadillacs or old American iron. And I only hope that Precision Miniatures takes this serious level of commitment and applies it to a stock street Cadillac someday soon. As a happy, not-so-coincidence, at around the time the limo was being designed, Motorhead Miniatures developed the perfect complement to the car, this driver figure. Now, I like things like this. They lighten the mood around the occasionally somber models, and this one's particularly well done. He's even tipping his hat. Now, for those collectors who enjoy adding figures to their display, this is a match made in heaven. Motorhead Miniatures also made the Fast Women lineup, and they have a habit of cranking out figures that really look like people. At a price of around 10 bucks, you just can't go wrong. Now, that's it for this episode of Playing with Cars. I want to thank you for coming down to the Car Room and sharing your time with us tonight. Until next time, for the Car Room Magazine, I'm Joe Kelly Jr. Thanks for stopping down, and thank you for playing with cars. Take care. Bye-bye.